This month's Seamaster opens at the first event of the 2013 Extreme Sailing Series. The tour is packed with new teams and new talent, and it kicks off in Muscat, Oman, the first event on an eight-stop tour. And as Emirates Team New Zealand prepares to pack and head to San Francisco for the America's Cup, the team relaxed for a humorous moment. But relaxation was not on the minds of Oman's youth sailors, with their hearts set on one goal, an Olympic medal. And it was too cold to relax in the Bay of Quiberon, where Oman's keelboat program was competing at Spee West, France. The 2013 Extreme Sailing Series began its eight-stop world tour in Muscat, Oman. With seven teams on the grid, old and new, the score sheet is clean. A new season, new lineups, and new hopes coming out of the winter break. Defending champions, the Wave Muscat are the team to beat, but a revitalised Red Bull sailing team is on a mission.
Red Bull are going to be strong. They're going to be fresh, looking to start again, you know, even better this year. So I think they're going to be a real challenge.
A nice lineup here, eight boats, some new teams, and I think it will be exciting racing again. So everything closer than last year. Really good names in the series now, and I think the young guns will push us quite hard, and will be a tough fight.
Hagara has been there before. Unlike newcomers Peter Berling and Blair Tuke, 49 are Olympic silver medalists who have joined Team Korea. But Kiwi rival William Tiller brings his match racing experience to GAC Pindar.
I'm supposing you can take a bit of match racing into this because it's such short course racing. There's probably a lot of small match racing situations that evolve. So to be honest, it's quite a big change up from what we're used to, but it's a good challenge, and yeah, we just want to get involved.
A new Swiss entry has also joined the fleet after Lake's success on their D35 catamaran. The team are looking to transfer Lake sailing skills to the extreme sailing circuit. The Wave Muscat not only won the tour last year, but with Omani Hashim Al Rashim on the bow, gave valuable Grand Prix experience to Oman Sail's grassroots youth program. This year, a new member of the Youth Academy joins the team, Musab Al-Hadi.
It's a new challenge for us, you know, changing the team. When you change, you know, a good formula, a winning formula from last year, it's going to present some new challenges. But straight away, he's shown us, you know, his strengths and his talent that it's, you know, absolutely clear. And, you know, we're feeling very good about the team this year and looking forward to improving and being one of the strong teams.
For Musab, this will be the greatest challenge of his life. 3 years ago, Musab's life was very different. Then he was a full-time fisherman in a small village north of Oman's capital, Muscat. Musab is 25. His family have been fishing the waters here for generations. A career he was set to take on until discovering the nation's emerging sail training program.
All my life I've been fishing. Suddenly, I see little boats over there in the Marina Bandarova, and I asking them, can we join you guys, or can we try that? I say, yeah, you can try, but you can't work because not chance now.
But persistence was key to his new opportunity. He got the chance to join.
Absolutely no experience about sailing, but I have experience about the wind and that sort of things, waves, where they come from and how.
Applying his instinctive knowledge of the seas, Musab has now become a rising star in the development program.
Oh yeah. This is nice fish. You have to accept that no pain, no gain, you know? It's hard job. Lee wants to achieve what he achieved last year. I will do everything I can to make that happen.
Musab has the whole year ahead of him. Singapore, China, Portugal, Istanbul, France, and ending in Rio de Janeiro in November. But it was his time to shine. Musab and his team performed and started the series where they left off in 2012, right at the front of the fleet. But as the focus moved from offshore to 3 days of stadium sailing, Could Red Bull overturn early on, as they're just 1 point behind? We join them in the final race on day two.
Final seconds to the start. Eight, seven, teams head six, towards the line, including five, Wave Musket, Lee McMillan. We're on board with GAC Pinder, the youngest crew, but they've not had a good start. It's a great start for the red and black sails of Alinghi. Team Career have a good start. Saw the Wave Musket up there as well. It's a very short opening leg. Team Career, brand new to the circuit this year. Are they leading the charge? Alinghi with the red and black sails, they're round the first mark. Big Jenikas are about to pop out. Bang, there they go. Left to pitcher, Switzerland Alinghi, going to the right-hand side of the course. The Wave Musket. Career are heading towards us. Well, two options to head downwind. SAP Extreme Sailing are looking good on the far side of the course, but there's two marks. You can go around either. Just 200 metres down to the bottom of the course. And Career, the brand new teams, far right of pitcher, are rounding in first position.
The newcomers were starting to enjoy themselves.
Team Career are really getting into their stride.
But the experienced heads on the Wave Musket, Red Bull Sailing Team and Alinghi were occupying the podium places.
There's been a lot of talk about Team Career on the dockside, just how good they could be. And in their first stadium race, they've gone out and won.
But at the top of the overall leaderboard were Red Bull and Alinghi, and we joined their fight at the start of race 13.
Red Bull Sailing squeeze round, Alinghi are controlling them on the inside. Two teams from the middle of Europe are controlling. Remember the course, it's down to the gate now. And Red Bull are on the outside, and they kept their momentum going as they rounded the mark. Alinghi stopped for a second, but they are going to jibe early. Red Bull, well, they've left it late to jibe, and Alinghi, I think, are going quicker now. There is more breeze in the middle of the race course. They're coming down towards the white marks. And that's Alinghi coming into picture and rounding the right-hand side. Interesting, they were going the left-hand side of the race course the first time. And Alinghi are about to complete a very, very good day. They have delivered the performance of the first day of stadium racing for 2013.
It was a useful second place for Red Bull, but a fifth for the Wave, leaving the defending champions a little phased. For double Olympic gold medalist Roman Hagara, this was shaping up to be a chance to avenge their painful end to 2012, where they finished fourth overall.
That is an agonising moment. Their season is falling apart in front of them. That's a cruel blow.
We had our chances last year. We started always quite good in the events, but then we had like always one day, which was like a nightmare for us. The most important race will be the last race, which is double points. And if you're still in there and fighting for the top spot, that would be the perfect scenario.
The Wave Muscats struggled to get a look in on day three, which is all about Red Bull, who recorded 3 wins and 4 seconds, giving them a 15-point lead going into the final day.
We've normally got a bit of a task on our hands. I'd say today's is quite a big one. 15 points to Red Bulls are going to be a big challenge. Although it's our home turf, we'd love to win here. We've got to be realistic, and you can't win them all.
Anything can change. We've lost 15 points before in the past. Not going to hedge our bets just now. See how the day goes and take it race by race.
But on the final race, the wind dropped and the tension increased.
The Wave Musket are going to slide straight past the Austrian team. And if it stays like this, the home teams will be champions in Amman.
But the Austrians weren't out of it.
Option of two marks. They're not going to follow the Wave Musket around the mark. This is Red Bull Sailing's last chance.
No, nice and smooth.
Final mark. Oh, look at that. That's the gain line between the Wave Muscat and Red Bull. Just says 2 meters between the boats. The Wave Muscat have got right of way. I think McMillan's done it. I think he's done it. The home team round ahead of Red Bull Sailing. I can't believe it. 15 points the advantage going into today. But the Wave Muscat, well, that says it all. Lee McMillan really did have an uphill struggle. The Wave Muscat are champions here in Oman.
What a comeback! Well done, boys. We've had some good comebacks on the last day, but I really didn't think we were going to be able to pull that one off. You know, Red Bull yesterday were just sensational, and today we had our day. We had some really good races, and we just really had the bit between the teeth. A good fight, it doesn't get any better than that when you come out on top. It's the best feeling.
But disappointment for Red Bull once again, letting such a convincing lead slip away. For the Wave Muscat and their new crew member, Moussab Al-Hadi, it's the perfect start to his professional sailing career. Coming up after the break, America's Cup entry Emirates Team New Zealand shows us the funny side. And Seamaster meets the rising stars of Oman's youth and keelboat programmes. Emirates Team New Zealand are coming to the tail end of their summer training in Auckland. In the last month, they've launched their second AC-72, followed by rigging their second wing.
I think we'll just get to lay line, OK?
They'd just a couple of weeks to test the new configuration before packing up camp to head to San Francisco and the Louis Vuitton Challenger trials. But even one of the most serious teams in the 34th America's Cup found time for some April the 1st humour.
And this America's Cup design is the heart.
I don't think there's ever been an instance where the slower boats won.
The weight and space on the boat and the functionality of what we're building are paramount. So when we put a new feature into the yacht, we have to know it's going to pay for itself.
I'm Nick Holroyd, I'm the technical director. I run the design group within the team.
Everything that you do is about not only designing the fastest boat, but finding ways to improve that boat. And so you're always looking for new features and new ideas on how to make the boat faster.
Although we want to take big gains all the time, if you can add up a lot of small gains, you'll end up with a big gain as well.
So our next performance enhancement has had a lot of input from the top end of the team.
If you look at two footy teams as they run out of the tunnel, they all look the same, but ultimately there'll be some ingredient in one of them that's slightly better.
Oh, well, we've had one of these on Chase One for quite some time, and the next thing, mate, we've got to get one on a big boat, so it's the job at hand.
Well, we thought it was important. You know, we're having issues with the support boat. They weren't really coming through as often as we'd like with good quality coffee. So we thought, well, the best way around this is to install a machine and be responsible for the coffee ourselves.
On the water, we're definitely finding the Ristretto capsules providing quite a hit. Performance is definitely measurable.
Well, we've experimented with a lot of different coffees out there. We're struggling with the latte. You know, we haven't got the fridge installed yet, but you know, that's sort of to come. But yeah, with the high apparent wind speeds, you know, we're struggling with the milk blowing back into the face of the other guys on the boat.
We've got to find an edge. And one of the things that we do in our daily life is we drink coffee all day. So why not take it out of the water and have an edge?
Yeah, Ray, can I grab a latte, please?
The coming winter of 2013 will see a huge influx to the peaceful coastline of Oman. Over 1,000 sailors will descend on the city of Mosana from over 50 nations to compete at the 2013 Laser World Championships. The host nation will be fielding a sailing team to compete on home waters. But it's been years in the making to produce sailors to survive at this level. Oman Sail's mission statement was to teach over 10,000 Omanis to sail. And they've achieved this in just 3 years. Oman Sail has produced athletes who have joined the top level of the sport, winning world championships and breaking records. But it's not just about the superstars. This is a grassroots program designed to perform long term. And part of the process is Musana Race Week, an annual regatta that attracts world-class sailors from all over the world.
So the last time I was here was almost 2 years ago, working with some of the young Omanis, and it's been incredible for me to come back here and spend a day with them and just to see how they've progressed. It's definitely has been a lot of good work been going on while I've been away, and the guys are coming through. And I think you see that now more on the world stage. You see the Omani name popping up here, there, and at regattas, and they're definitely on the up. The big thing is having the right people in place to provide the support that the sailors need. You don't win an Olympic medal overnight. It's all about spending time at regattas and working your way up through the system.
One athlete to come out of the program with some promising results is Hussein Al-Jabri. For a young man from a modest background in the town of Yiti, sailing isn't the typical career path. But after seeing an advert on Facebook, he gave the selection trials a go and hasn't looked back.
I grew up by the sea, and my relationship with it began when I was young, when I started sailing with my father. My only dream is to compete in the Olympics as an Omani champion and raise high the flag of the Sultanate, and I'll inshallah achieve this dream.
For Hussein, this event was about turning training into competition. But he was up against stiff international competition, including Laser ISAF World Cup winner Australian Tom Burton and Olympic gold medalist Paul Goodison. Hussein finished 20th, a solid mid-fleet position and a result that puts him on target to qualify for the Worlds. Earlier on in the programme, Seamaster Sailing met the new recruit on the wave Muscat, Musab Al-Hadi. Musab also campaigns his F-18 catamaran dinghy. Last September, he was forced to retire from the World Championships with a hand injury after winning the opening race. But he's now back for Musana Race Week, the first event on his 2013 programme.
I had a plan, actually, last 2 years. Since I've been on F-18, just had a clear plan that just I want to compete in the Olympic Games. And yeah, I'm gonna work as hard as I can just to be there and be the champion.
Musab battled all week with the French pairing of Gervain Bonton and Benjamin Amiot, finishing just 1 point off the top spot.
The week's been really good in Musana Race Week, actually. We had a different and high experience level from the competitors comparison the last year. Battling from the beginning of the regatta, just 1 point till the end. So that means, yeah, fighting it till the end, that's what it's all about.
Overall, the unique coaching and regatta formula of Musana Race Week has been a success and a major contributor to Omani sailing development.
Oman has the opportunity with its program to be the leading force just within this area. You could see how many sailors from Qatar and from Bahrain and from Abu Dhabi and other Arab states, Gulf states, were here this week. As it continues to develop its program, it will actually help the neighboring states piggyback on that success. And it could become the major force in sailing in this part of the world.
Musab and Hussein are on track to make an international impact, while Oman Sail is gearing up to stage the Laser World Championships in just a few months' time.
I think the venue's fantastic, just having the hotel right here on the beach, ready next to the boats, the slipways being good, and being so close to the race course. There's not many venues where it's literally 5 minutes sail and you're at the committee boat ready to go. So all the facilities are world class, the weather conditions being good, and the sailing's been really good.
The Spee West France Easter Regatta is usually a marker of the beginning of summer sailing in France. But this year, sub-zero temperatures and strong winds made life challenging and uncomfortable. As part of Oman Sail's keelboat program, the women's team competed in the largest class of the regatta, the J80, alongside 109 other teams.
Cold, windy, wavy, and little ice. Come on, it's the first time for us in this ocean, and it was, and even the wind, it's come more and more and more. This is the first time for us to be in such a big competition. A little bit worried about it, but we're gonna do our best, and we're not afraid, but we are confident, and we have the confidence just to complete the races, and we wish that we're gonna be okay, and we're gonna get a good result.
The women's team's results improved throughout the regatta as they got to grips with high winds and big seas. It's one more step up a big learning curve as they prepare for the J80 Worlds in Marseille this July. The men's team, however, was a different story. Skippered by Cédric Poligny, they punched in some top results in their M34 against stiff competition. A handful of firsts and seconds put the team in fifth overall, behind their old rival from 2011 Sail Arabia the Tour, Daniel Subban, who won the class.
Actually, the weather, it's difficult for us because it's different in Oman. We come here to work hard, so the Arab, when they want to do something, they forget everything. The weather, the raining, the snows, everything. But it's really cold here than Oman.
Next month on Seamaster Sailing, we're back with the RC44 Tour in Trapani, Italy, for their second stage of the 2013 World Tour. Plus more action from the Extreme Sailing Series in Singapore and a form check on the 2016 Olympic hopefuls as the first European ISAF World Cup event takes place in Palma, Mallorca.